Hello, myself Jay Tandel from Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Technical Education and Research Center, Navsari. Today we are going to learn about a most important subject of waste to energy. So today is only introduction, basic introduction of waste to energy. So now first, what is the need for waste to energy? So the amount of soil waste generated each year has been increasing much faster than the population growth. So growing the demand of energy is also increases. Today we face numerous environment and economical challenges like population growth and associated waste disposal needs, global warming and dependent on fossil fuel. We know that we have a limited source of non-conventional sources called petroleum, so on. So we are already think about the second sources, and we are already moving towards that, the renewable sources. But that is not a till solution. Our population growth is increased day by day, so energy requirement that will be, and this waste that will be in the, some of the country. Some of the state which is directly heated, and whatever the pollutions, it pollute there ultimately and land too. So we are think about whatever that waste, how to convert from waste to the best. So whatever the waste that is that can be converted into the heat form, and that heat form through the running turbine, we ultimately generate electricity. So we are think about that, and which is already implemented after 2001 in India, right? There are so many private sectors as well as the government sector is looking for that. So there is a common solutions of the all these challenges, and the energy from the waste that is called as a EFW, which provide a safe economical waste disposal, greenhouse gas reduction and renewable source. Now what is waste to energy? So the waste to energy technologies utilize the MSW, that is called as a municipal soil waste, to increase the electric and heat energy through the various complex conversion method. So WTE, that is called as a waste to energy technology, is provide the alternating source of renewable energy in the world with limited or challenging a fossil reversal. Now MSW is considered a source of renewable energy because it contained a large amount of biological and renewable materials. So there is a significant excess supply to MSW primary in land lift. Now land lift, what is land lift, we discuss later. Around the global world, the demand for MSW as a fuel source that will be increases. So most common conversion method of MSW to energy is the combustion process, and through it currently entrance in the market, there are three energy technology moving towards the forward. Now municipal soil waste, that is called as a MSW technology. So what is that MSW? So MS is a full form, MSW is, that is a municipal soil waste, is the waste typically collected and managed by the local municipalities. We know our society which having some special vehicle by the Nagarpalika that collect all the that waste door to door. So it is a predominantly a waste generated by the household and collected from the household or from the area which household have access to deposit their waste. It is also, so land lift means whatever the waste, it may be agriculture waste, it may be a industrial waste, it may be a rural waste, whatever that waste that will be collected at particular place, that is called as a land lift. We are deposit that waste at particular area, it is maybe wide area, so that is called as a land lift. It is also included the waste of similar natural derived from the commercial and industrial weight sections. So, that WTE technology, which is divided into three major parts. First, that is a thermal conversion. Second, that is a biochemical conversion, and third, that is a landfill gas. So, thermal conversion further divided into three. Combustion, as I told you, combustion is a very basic method for to generate the waste from the waste or waste to energy. Gasification and pyrolysis, and in case of biochemical conversion, that is anaerobic digestion. So, in this conversion technology, thermal having a three types, that is combustion, gasification and pyrolysis. So, there are multiple technology of the conversion MSW to energy, but this technology are not in a competition with each other, they are parallelly working. So, incineration of the waste is the most prevalent form of converting MSW to energy. The waste is combusted, heated, or we can say biogas is created from that, is harnesses and either distributed as heat or converted into the form of some steam, and ultimately that steam which is imparted, dry steam imparted on the turbine blades, that will be ultimately generate some energy. So, combustion process is classified as a mass burn combustion, where the waste is not a pre-sorted, or it is called as a RDF combustion, which means a refuse derived fuel. RDF means refuse derived fuel. Now, it is a most costly process, where the recyclable material are sorted from the rest of the waste. This process is called as a SRF, that is called as a solid recovery fuel combustion process. Another process that is called as a gasification, which is effective in minimizing the air pollution. Gasification occurs in the presence of limited oxygen and generate synthetic gases, that is called CH4, SNG gases we oftenly call, to use for the generate the heat and ultimately electricity from the turbine, gas turbine. And the third process that is called as a pyrolysis process. So, this is a thermochemical process that produces the SNG gases, that is called as the synthetic gases. And most recently cellulosic ethylene. This process can be used to waste from the, we are generating some fuel energy, fuel, basic fuel we are generated from the gasifications. The anaerobic digestion is the biological process, is a treatment where the organic material is treated and the output biogas is rich in the methane. So, the biogas can be cleaned and used, turned into the heat and ultimately electricity generated. Now, I want to tell you about some CNG gases. So, that is called as a synthetic gases, is a fuel gas which is mixed consisting primarily of the hydrogen, carbon monoxide and very often some carbon dioxide. So, the name comes from it used as a intermediated in creating the synthetic natural gas, that is called as SNG, and for producing the ammonia or methanol. Now, I want to show you some graph regarding to the this three combustion, SRF and anaerobic digestion. So, you can see before 2016, that is only combustion process. We are what we are doing, whatever the waste we are heated and try to evaporate it into atmosphere, but they are generating lots and lots of carbon dioxide. So, that process of combustion that will be modified in such a manner, whatever that heat energy that will be utilized to generate a steam, and as a whatever the steam generated, which is there are some conservator process, there are some 3 to 5 type process like thermal power plant, and ultimately finally we get some wet steam, and that wet steam imparted some pressure on blades, it will be rotated and then we are generating the process. That is a combustion process of any material which is converted into form of heat, right. So, to the 2020, you see the energy from the combustion, SRF and anaerobic digestions, we are generating from the waste energy. That is up to the level of ultimately 35 tons, right? So these are the year versus tons watt hour graph. Now WTT plant design. WT, that is waste to energy plant design. You can see there are the plant that will be that having a five sections. First section, that is nitrogen oxide removal system, because whatever we are combusted, we are not directly dissipated chemical polluted air directly to the atmosphere. So we are utilize that energy, we are heated that waste, but we are purifying and dissipated in the atmosphere at some lower level of polluted air. So first process, that is a nitrogen oxide removal system. Second, there is a mercury and dioxide removal system. Third, that is acid gate removal system. Fourth, that is particular removal system. And fifth, that is pollution control test. So you said the dumpers, which is dumped waste, that will be some process that is called as a trash storage blanket, and it will be clipped it and put on the heat area. It will be generate some steam, so some form of steam that will be utilized for the turbine blades and ultimate electricity. Some of the fluid gases that will be on from the section of 2, 3 and 4, it will be filtered out and then dissipated in heat. I want to tell you that whatever the S is generated, which can be also used for the some other purpose in agriculture basis. So these are the basic block of the plant, WTE plant diagrams. Now MSW, treatment through the gasification and pyrolysis, which is another two method from waste to the waste, or waste to energy to waste to the energy, WTE. So gasifications are the type of thermal, both are gasification and pyrolysis are the thermal treatment used to convert the MSW to energy. A gasification is the process that use the high temperature without combustion to decomposite the material to produce the SNG gases. So SNG gases is generally used to the power gas engine or turbine to generate the heat or electricity, but can also be used to the fuel itself. As I told you, SNG gases can be used as a basic fuels, fuel sources. So which is intermediated in the producing the other fuel and the chemicals. The using the SNG gas to generate the heat or electricity is more efficient than the combustion MSW. SNG gases can use to produce the synthetic diesels. This liquid from the SNG gases is cleaner and more efficient than the other liquid fuels. So this is the thing, basic thing about gasification process. Now I want to tell you about some the pyrolysis process. Pyrolysis has been demonstrated at a pilot and small commercial scale advertisement to the large scale could be the game changer. So the pyrolysis is the advance from the gasification that chemically decomposes the organic material by the heat in the absence of oxygen. This process is typically occurs under the pressure at very high operating temperature, around some 500 degrees Celsius. So bio oil, gas, that are produced by the this pyrolysis process. The bio oil is purified liquid renewable energy sources, which can be used to produce the power and heat from the industrial boilers. So pyrolysis as a waste to energy technology has been piloted and beginning to the test in the market for the some high for the industrial purpose most probably. Pyrolysis is also reaching the commercializations in the production of the cellulosic ethanol. that is a chemically called CH4. This is a course outcome. We have 3 lectures, no practical, ultimately credit 3. We have a 70 mark theory, meet 30 marks, there is no internal. So ultimately 100 marks from this subject. First chapter, that is introduction to energy from the waste. So today we are discussed introduction and some gasification and the digesters process. That is ultimately a conversion process. So remaining topic, that is the agro based, forest residual, industrial waste, MSW, that are already we cover in this introduction lecture. Second chapter, that is biological, biomass, all these lectures that is regarding to the biomass process. I refer the Desai Osokvi, that is a non-conventional energy source which is available in our library. Another book which is handbook, and from last chapter, that is food feed and from the biomass. So there are some reference books, there are some practical handbooks are there, you can refer any from that. So nextly we are discuss about the classification of waste as fuel, agro based and forest residual, industrial waste. Thank you.